Welcome to another lecture of Mechanics of Material 1. Today is lecture 2. We are going to review what we have just seen on the board. So let me show myself. Okay. On the board, we will see a review of theory for the case of variable axial loading. So I will not show my face anymore. Let's go directly to the board. Okay. We started today's lecture with the review of the concepts we have seen last week about axial loading. We have the definition of change in length, the definition of axial stress, the definition of the unit strain, and obviously Hooke's law in 1D. Here we have the drawing, and this was the basic case last week. Today, we move to a new case that involves variable axial loading, that is, the case when we have a different cross-section for a bar subjected to axial loading. And we can see here in the formula for the stresses that we have to use the area of the cross-section for each segment. And the important thing is that when we calculate the total deformation, we have to use the length for each segment. And each of these deformations, deltas, will have a different sign. So we have to be careful to include the lengths for each segment and maybe the sign of the force. This is case one, variation in the cross section. We can have as many segments as we want. And the thing is that the stress, the actual stress, sigma x, is going to be different due to the change in the cross section. Okay? The students continue to work in teams using our steel case notes chairs. And let's see now what is case two. Case two, we have a variation in the axial load as well as the variation in the cross section. And you can see that in this problem, this example, we have the appearance of a reaction force. The first thing you have to do is to calculate this reaction by using global equilibrium, expressed there on the board. And in order to calculate the total deformation at the end D of the bar, you have to calculate the deformation of each segment. Each deformation will come into this equation with their own sign. So pay attention to the sign of each deformation. Okay? And in here, we have the evaluation of the internal forces. The internal forces are needed in the calculation of the axial stresses and the deformations of each segment. And you can see that, for instance, for the segment AB, you use the internal force AB and the cross-section, the area AB. And for the deformation, you use the length of the section AB, of the segment AB, as well as the area AB. You use sections, like in statics, to find the internal forces and local equilibrium there to express the internal forces in terms of the reaction RA. The same for the second segment. And finally, for the third segment is the same. You need to be careful, that's why there is a red asterisk there in each equation, because the signs might be different for each of the segments of the bar. Okay, and once you have these deformations, you can just come back here to this equation to calculate the total deformation. Well, that was today's lecture. Students continue to work on their problem set number one, section two of that problem set. You can find it in Blackboard. And again, I'll see you next time. Greetings from Campus Puebla of Tec de Monterrey. See you.